Hey, what's going on, everybody? I'm Chris. I'm here with Kathy. We go by Ginger Marvin on Instagram and YouTube. We have another What's Old video for you today. It's actually Sunday night. We're trying to get a head start on tomorrow's, on the sales over the weekend. I think we've had quite a few, so we're going to start following Kathy around to see what's sold for us today.
All righty. Let's start with Mercari, B-E. Some keys. So these are from my 65 pair day. They sold on Mercari for $20 plus shipping. That was an offer I accepted. And yeah, I only had about $4 in change into those. So that 65 pair day, I was just looking today, and I think I'm down to 20 pairs left. So I've sold 45 in just a few weeks.
Very nice. Yeah.
BD here. Oh my gosh, I did not write. Okay, this is what it was. I didn't write what it was. That was in here. Alright, it was these books. I paid $10.99 for these at Goodwill. They sold for $35 plus shipping on Mercari. And then AC. This is just something we recently pulled from the closet. Normally these can sell for a good amount. It's like a Nike Storm men's pullover, like a golf thing. But the Storm ones do usually really well, like around $30. But this one, I don't even know what to say about it. Like the inside of it was like all peeling and stuff, which I showed in the listings. But for that reason, I listed it low and then accepted a $12 offer just to move it, because it's been hanging there for a year probably. I only paid $3.53 for it, so still made a little profit. Glad to see it go. I've been up, had one Poshmark sale so far. I think it's just on this table somewhere. Maybe not. Oh. This one, I know. I'm gonna fall off. Oh well. Literally, where are those Spanx that were here?
I thought you had, yeah, they're right behind you. You had me set them up on the shelf back there so we wouldn't get them lost in the pile. Sorry, we've been cooped up in our house. It has been a blizzard here in Colorado. So we've been cooped up. We're ready to get out of the house, but.
You know, it's been one whole day.
Yeah. It's different when you're not allowed to leave the house.
Yeah, we're stuck here. All right, so, yeah, these are just a pair of Spanx. I paid $7 for them at Goodwill. They sold for an offer of $35 that I accepted. I probably could have got more, but they had like some deep wrinkles like that I don't think are gonna come out. And I noted that and everything and showed pictures, but yeah. So for that reason, I was happy with $35. So I make $28 after the posh fee. It's about a $20 profit. I did want to mention that Viviana, one of our viewers, also bought something from me this weekend, and I had to cancel her order because I no longer have the item. I sold it months ago on Kidizen and just forgot to delete it. It was an item that I had multiple quantity of, just the size that she bought. I only had one of, and that one sold, and I forgot to delete that size off of Poshmark. So be careful with your multi-quantity listings. But yeah, so sorry, Viviana. I love that shirt too. I kept one for myself. So
thank you for the support anyway, Viviana.
If
you are,
I ever find another one, I will definitely tag you.
Yeah.
All right, and then we had, we had two more Facebook sales. So BK.
Right over here.
What was it? Some Keens again. Oh, yeah. These were also from my 65 pair day. They also sold for $20 plus shipping. The other one was a Chris sale, the Happy Days Viewmaster thing.
See, and I haven't even, I've got my pile still over here. Let me dig it out real quick. I guess I'll talk about it. So today I sold this Happy Days Viewmaster sealed in package. It looks like it's dated 1977, 78.
Gosh, that's crazy to me.
This was actually another thing that I think we got from your uncle, who's no longer with us. We got that
the card,
that Star Wars card that sold yesterday, or not yesterday, a couple days ago. And this was in his stuff also. So that sold for how much?
$20 plus shipping.
$20 plus shipping. So
free to us.
Pretty good sale there, I think.
All right, so that was it for Facebook. And then I had a number of Kidizen sales today because we, if you didn't see our live, we did a live, not cross-posting, but relisting. I'm relisting my whole closet. Today I did around 100 items, and I've already sold 4 of them, so plus a couple other things. So this one was not a relisted item, but it is something that just sold today. These little bogs, I paid $5.99 for them at a local thrift, and they sold for $45 free shipping. Shipping cost me $5, so really good profit there. And then a box of J. Your orange self. Alright. This is just a little tank top. It says like a beast. I bought this off ThreadUp because I was gonna keep it for my son, but it was too small for him, so I just listed it. I only paid $7 for it, and I sold it for $13.85 free ship, so made my $7 back, but that's about it. Alright, and then CJ. This was just relisted as well. It's just a Nike shirt. Was one of my son's, but he never wore it. It's still new with tag. And I got it at the Dillard's discount. I don't remember how much. I probably bought it 4 years ago. Probably $6 to $8 total. And I sold it for $9 plus ship. So just trying to move some stuff at this point. And then box AP.
Don't step on Reeser.
Mario. Another one of my son's hoodies. So I also got this on ThreadUp. I bought it for $12. I sold it for $19.95 free ship. He wore it a few times. So shipping was $5. I think I lost 4 cents on this. So no big deal there. And then, last but not least, was a bundle sale. And these were 2 relisted items. One of them is actually right here, because she had asked me for measurements on it, so I pulled it out. So it's just a Quicksilver t-shirt, and the other one is a Quicksilver tank at CQ. So there's that one. So she paid $28.24 for the both of them. I only paid $5.10 for the both of them, and the shipping is $3.85, so make some profit off of those. So yeah, that was that. I think that's that whole sticky. Let me grab my eBay sticky.
It's a 2 sticky night.
Yeah. This eBay is double-sided. All right, so on the table, another item that sold was this one I just listed. It was also my son's. I listed a bunch of their stuff this weekend. So yeah, this is a Quicksilver rash guard and the chunks. Sold for $17.76 free shipping. I only got that off Kidizen for $8, and my son wore it like all last summer, so that was a good purchase because I made all my money back in a little pocket, and he wore that all last summer, so
that's can't beat how that.
We like to do it. All right, and then this person, she bought 2 pairs of little baby Keens, so she must have twins or something. These are both from the Nordstrom Clear the Rack, so about $9 into each pair. And she bought them both for $50 plus shipping. That was awesome. Box U. Right, so these are some Ultra shoes. They are missing the insoles, but they were only $5, so I took a chance on them. I had them listed around $25, I think. Someone asked today if I'd take 18. Because I only paid $5 and I had it listed as, what is it, calculated shipping, I knew he was going to be overpaying at least $1 or $2 on the shipping. So I accepted the $18 because I would have probably set an offer for $20 anyways. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think I still profited like $11 or $12 off of them. Yeah. All right, so DK.
Uh-oh, that's the top.
Ugh. Get rid of the little
I had ambitions of building more shelves along that wall. and kind of like where this table is, like an island. And those will be going in those one of those places when I build that. So
I sold another pair of the Hurley swim trunks. I have 6 into these, and they sold for $29 plus ship. Sold a lot of swim this weekend.
Yeah.
BS, another swim item. These ones are Quicksilver, and I did pay $10 for these, and they sold for $26.66 plus shipping. It's like, these are the things I bought after summer last year, and like I knew they probably wouldn't. I mean, I've sold a lot throughout the year, but now they're really starting to sell off.
So right.
I'll probably be sold out of them by 2 more months, I would say.
Yep.
All right, so AN, another pair of swim trunks. On the way over there. These ones are not new, and actually they didn't sell that well because they've been in the closet, because after I bought them, got them home, I saw a bunch of, you cannot see it in normal light, I swear, but when I put them under the photo lights, there's just like little faint marks. So I got pictures of them, and I listed them low because of it, but it's just Oakley swim trunks. I bought them for $5, they sold for $13.30 plus ship. Without the marks, I could have got $25 free ship or so. I just like selling swim trunks, so I usually pick any good brands up for $5 or under. All right, and then Q.
Over here.
This is just a little baby Patagonia sun hat. I sent an offer of $20 free ship on this because I've had it for a while. I got it off ThreadUp for $5.99, and the shipping was like $3. It's super lightweight. So I made a small profit, but yeah, I probably could have got more if I held off. Someone actually just messaged on Facebook because I forgot to delete it, saying, is this still available? So thankfully she messaged and didn't just buy it, because
right.
Then I would have had to cancel. All right, and then DL. Oh, gosh.
The other one.
Never go in these boxes.
Right.
What's in here? All the swim trunks. So we'll probably be in here a lot for you.
You should probably get that car out of there. I feel like you're going to pull it down one day. It's going to drive right in your face.
So these are a pair of those cloth and stone linen wide leg pants. I have several of them. I paid $7 for each. These ones sold for $25 plus shipping. Right, and then AI. Columbia sandals. So these ones, I actually bought on Kidizen as part of a bundle deal. They get a better price on an item I wanted to keep. So I did pay $7.49 for them, and I only sold them for $12 plus shipping. So just making my money back on those. And then DD, some Crocs. Fit a lot in that box. So these Crocs sold for $20 plus shipping. That was an offer I sent out. I got those a while back. Those ones took a while to sell. I think I just listed them in the wrong season. But yeah, I paid $8 for them, so not the best. CH. So these Nike Flyknits. I had a buyer ask if I would take 36. Mostly because, again, I had these as calculated shipping, and once he accepted my offer, I saw his shipping was like $13.90 or something, so I think he wanted to be right at $50 or under because he paid $49.90, so. Anyways, I accepted his offer of $36. I had bought them for $12.99, so about a $20 profit. I was happy with that. I already pulled these out just so that we didn't have to knock the whole tower down, but sold another pair of these play sandals. These ones sold for $26.50 plus shipping. I have $10 into them. Box L.
Oh no! Sticky down!
Right. So these are some Keens for my 65 pair a day. These ones sold for $22.21 free ship. Shipping's about $3.50 on those. All right, And then, CI, oh, this was the good sale that we mentioned. What was it, yesterday's video? And she hadn't paid yet, or she paid,
but
didn't clear, but it finally cleared today, so. This is the brand, I don't know, that's what it is. I don't know the brand, but.
Nadia?
Nandita?
Yeah. Sounds fancy.
So I just felt like it was fancy, like it was a nice dress, the tag looks nice. So I did look it up. I did pay $30 for this at Marshall's, but when I looked it up, it was like a few hundred dollars retail. So I figured I could probably get half of that. But I ended up getting 99 plus ship, so.
Wow.
Not quite half of probably retail, but I'm happy with 99
super
plus
happy,
ship.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it was like about right at $50 profit. And it did take a while to sell, but when you are selling $100 items, they usually take a while to sell. So. Alright, and then I sold this third leg bra. This one sold for 20 plus ship on eBay. And then I have like two more, I think. Box Q. This one sold to a viewer. Where is it? It's small. No. Found it. Literally under the last thing.
Oh.
So this
yeah.
is a little eyeliner and it sold to Kelly. So she bought this for, I think I sent her an offer. I didn't know she was a viewer or anything at that time. $4.88 plus shipping. So thank you so much,
yeah.
Kelly. This came from my FabFitFun box, so I've already broke even on what I spent on the box, so $3 something profit for me to go buy a coffee with when we can leave the house again.
Thank you so much for the support, Kelly. We appreciate it.
And then I'll put these back, but the last sale was Chris, one that Chris did.
Oh. I'll go back to this pile over here. So, I sold my childhood Spider-Man comic book, one of my comic books, the only one that I've listed so far. What did it sell for?
I lost my sticky, so I don't know. I think my sticky got shipped in that bag. It was like 35 something.
Yeah. We lost the sticky. we'll pull it up. But yes, this amazing Spider-Man comic book, this is dated 1992, so I just remember having this basically as long as I could remember. And it sold for, I think, 30 something. But this one's actually pretty cool. This is the first appearance of Morbius. And there's a Avengers Endgame comic book ad in this comic, which is kind of cool because it looks like the movie poster for the Endgame movie with Thanos and all that kind of stuff.
So it's $35.56 plus $4.58 shipping, and
okay.
It was global shipping too. So.
Oh yeah, I think it was going to like Canada or something. So $35.56, and it's global shipping going to Canada. So, I think we're gonna pack it up in some cardboard, and yep, it'll be on its way. So that's pretty much it for our what sold for tonight, right?
Yes.
So we're gonna go ahead and get this stuff all packed up and we'll meet you guys back in the morning. Hey guys, I kind of wanted to show you this ad in this Spider-Man comic book. So I said Endgame, but it's actually Infinity War. And I thought this was a pretty cool advertisement when I was looking through here before I listed it. So I thought that was neat. Also, today happened to be Pi Day 3.14 and we've been snowed in, so we kind of improvised and made.
I haven't tried it yet, because I don't really like pudding, and it's just pudding.
It's some chocolate pudding and some puff pastry, so that's what happens when you want pie and it's a blizzard out.
I don't want that pie. I wanted like peanut butter pie or something.
Oh.
Or like raspberry pie with whipped cream.
Yeah. Well, this is what we got because we're snowed in, so. All right, we'll see you guys in the morning. All right, guys, we're back. Got this stuff all packed up last night. Got a few more sales. Kathy's got her post-it note ready.
Yeah.
The snow is melting off. We got a few big drifts in the front here. Hard to get a view of it, but so yeah, we're just plugging away again today. So what do we got going out today?
Maybe like 9 or 10. Alright, so first one, we had another Poshmark sale. These are some Hokas. They weren't in the best shape, so someone offered me 40 and I accepted. I only paid $5.99 for them. Then, AU had another Kidizen sale last night. This is just a boys O'Neill, like a striped t-shirt. Nothing fancy, but it sold for $16.85 free ship. That just got relisted and then sold right away. What was I gonna say? Oh, I paid $3 for that, and then shipping was $3.85, so. All right, then BR. From my stimulus check challenge. So from the bins, I have around $1 into them. They sold for 15 plus ship. The brand is Arco Pedico, something like that. This brand normally does really well for me, but these ones had a weird thing going on the sole. So that's why I let them price drop all the way down to 15. But yeah, it's still not too bad. $1 into 15 plus ship. And CT, you guys have seen several of these. This is the last one. So, shouldn't have to see them anymore unless I find some that I forgot to list. But the Ultra Crop Tops, this one sold for 19 plus ship. I only have a couple bucks into it, $3 or so, I think. And then I have another bra in here that's sold.
The bras are selling.
Do sell fast. It makes, even though I'm not enjoying listing them, it makes me want to get more after we list off. Alright, so this one.
What are the chances of you finding another 50 bras at the like bins?
There's tons of bras at the bins. I normally just don't grab them. These I grab because even before I looked at the brand, I saw that they just looked like they were almost new. So
yeah.
Yeah, this one is just a racer back style. And yeah. That one sold on Mercari last night for 18 plus ship. I have nothing into them at this point, so yeah, all profit there. And then had some eBay sales. What is Reese doing?
I don't know. What you doing, Reese? You're just making a bunch of noise.
So on eBay, I sold these. They're just like Hanes, the wife beater tank tops. These came in my thread up men's box, which is a horrible, horrible box. This might be the first and only thing I've sold from that box, so I know I won't make my whole money back. But these sold for $5.14 plus shipping, so I made like $4 back so far. Thankfully, you guys watched our video, so it'll probably offset the cost of the box at least, so that I won't lose money. But
yeah, we're not huge fans of the mystery box.
No, it's fun. Like, I like it, but I don't like paying for it with my money.
Yeah.
But if anyone wants to join ThreadUp with our code and then give me credit, then I'll get another one.
Yeah, well, that's something we could use ThreadUp credit with mystery boxes.
I think they get like $10 or $20 something to spend.
Okay.
So, yeah, we'll get
there was a link in the description, so.
Do we? I was like, I don't know if we have our ThreadUp link, but.
I think we do. I think I put it in there. Okay. I'll check.
Well, these are some Keens, and they sold for $25 plus shipping. That was an offer I sent a watcher. I only paid $5.99 for those. BH these are just some Johnny O shorts. They sold for $29.55 free shipping. They're only about 10 ounces, so shipping will be around $4.50 on those. And I bought them at TJ Maxx, like a clearance sale for $8. You all right, Reese?
You scratch. Reese is getting a little bit chunky now that he's a single dog.
We've never fed our dogs table scraps until.
Now he gets them all. Reese.
Two light blue ginghams in the same box. All right, so this is just a Vineyard Vines button down. It was my son's. Don't know where I got it, but it sold for $17.76 free ship. Shipping's about $3. It's only about a 3 ounce shirt. So yeah, that was it for this morning so far.
All right, so we'll get this stuff packed up and we'll be right back. All right, we got the rest of that packed up, ready to go to the post office, and we had one more sale that came in, and we'll just pull it real quick.
All right, so this is just the Hurley Boys tank top. It sold for 13.47 free ship. That was an offer I sent out because we've had these for a while. I only have about $3 into it, maybe a little bit less. So yeah, and shipping was right around $3. It's a super lightweight shirt. So yeah.
All right. That is going to do it for this What Sold video. Now, a couple days ago, we did mention our Poshmark. There was two sales in there that never showed as delivered, but they were from like October. And what, like February, something like that. So, and we emailed Poshmark, they responded, they cleared it all up. So we did double check, make sure that that money was in there. The transactions weren't, but the money was. So I'm just imagine that was probably put in place where it was. We just couldn't go back far enough or something, but the money was there. We added it all up and figured it out. So I would suggest checking out your Poshmark closets and seeing for yourself.
You gotta add that to the end of the
yeah month. That's probably something we're gonna start doing regularly, every month or two maybe, especially with this past season of the USPS kind of being crazy and super delayed on a lot of stuff. So I think it's definitely worth checking out, making sure you are getting your money for things that are delivered. They just don't show delivered. So that's going to do it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.